There was a time in America when you had to go out to see a movie, making it a big deal, and making many movie houses no mere houses at all, but often ornate and palatial destinations by themselves.
Here on Exeter Street in Boston's Back Bay, the landmark Exeter Theater was one of those movie palaces for 70 years. Today, it's a Montessori school, and almost all of the other movie palaces everywhere have been downsized to decaplexes, all owned by regional or national chains, but there are some hardy, surviving movie houses where the show does go on independently.
It's a local movie theater. We show mostly specialized art films, but family films for the community as well. People call it funky, call it original.
David Bramante just calls it his own and has run the independent West Newton Cinema for the past 40 years, although he used to have a lot more local company.
They were in all the towns around here, Wellesley, Needham, Waltham, and they've all been shut down.
So what does it say about the survivors, that they've survived?
Determined, love for the business. It's a business that really gets in your system and you stay with it.
Bramante's loyal customers are glad he has.
We've both lived in Newton for a long time, and it's just nice to have a movie theater that is close and we can go to spontaneously.
The theater opened in December 1937 with a full-time staff that dwarfs today's slim crew. Yes, that's the present owner working the ticket counter. No tuxedo either, you'll note. But outside as inside, there is a certain continuity.
Not a lot has changed here. Is that part of the lure?
I think it, in a way, yeah, the nostalgia is always nice. Some people would like to see some upgrades, and we've done things. We've upgraded to digital cinema, which was a big investment for us.
It doesn't change much.
Is that part of the charm?
Mostly the quality
Mostly
of the movies.
The quality
On Thayer Street in Providence, the owner of the landmark Avon Theater has heard the same comments.
You're not going to close, are you? And it's like, as long as you come, I'll be here, you know.
Richard Dolgarian and his family have now been here owning and operating this throwback theater since 1938.
Whether it's your independent hardware store, your independent movie theater, we're offering something to the public that the big guys can't, and that's a history. We have a sheet there where people are writing their memories. Like, I came here on my first date, and now it's 25 years later, and I'm back here with my husband and my two children.
Let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a treat.
The longtime traditions here certainly appeal to its regulars, from the art house films themselves to, well, talk about classics. Made fresh popcorn with, yes, real butter. At the same time, Richard Dolgarian knows the world outside his theater has changed.
Three generations ago, we sold out every seat, every performance. Somehow we still are needed. People still want to have a communal experience.
In South Weymouth's Columbian Square, the Cameo Theater has also been a fixture since the 1930s. Today, its lights are still on, only because a local couple saved it in 2011.
The previous owner did not want to invest in the digital equipment, which, you know, we totally understand because it's a crazy move, but we just didn't want it to close.
So Michelle and Brett Hardy invested in digital, expanded to two screens, installed new seats, preserved the historic lobby, remained determined to show first-run movies, and, oh yeah, didn't pass along the costs to their customers, who are also their neighbors.
For us to come here and take the kids, see a movie, and get popcorn and drinks, it's under $50.
Yeah.
And they're a great neighbor.
And mind you, being an independent theater owner doesn't mean being independently wealthy.
We both have other unrelated full-time jobs. And for us, it works well because the hours that are required at the movie theaters are based at night and when people are off from work.
But it is a labor of love in more ways than one. Brett Hardy began working at a movie theater as a teen, working his way up from concessions to manager to projectionist, a role he still fills now at his own theater.
Almost every town used to have a small town movie theater. Now they're very rare. It would be a shame to lose that.
So in South Weymouth, this local cinema lives on. And now at the end of a long work and movie day, there's a theater to tidy up before doing it all again tomorrow.